the lead interventional radiologist. So I had some hopes that they would do a good study, and they didn't. So in my own views, I think that the technical aspects of this procedure are not intuitive. If you model the angioplasty on the usual treatment of a standard venous stenosis, you're treating the wrong thing. So the third thing is that balloon sizing of the vessels is absolutely critical. Unless you're really good at assessing the size of something from a non-one-to-one visual image, which I can't do. Those were the technical issues that I saw, that they didn't use really big balloons. They didn't use high-pressure balloons. They didn't try hard enough. For example, they were allowed to only blow up the balloon twice. I've blown the balloon up 6 to 10 times. And I'm not satisfied with a residual 40% stenosis as an endpoint. Because if there's a residual stenosis, it suggests that the original stenosis has only been stretched and not broken apart. And I think those are the biggest problems I have with that study on the technical side. I thought blinding was really pretty imaginative, so for me, the failure of the study was in the study design, not in the study treatment. I don't think they got enough technical consensus before they started the procedure. I found it curious that an operative procedure was designed by a non-operative physician. And their advisor was somebody who abandoned the field because there were too many, among the reasons were that there were too many complications, and they had given up on the idea. So it was like a nihilistic approach, and I was very, very unhappy with the results. To subsequently find out that they opened the they reported the trial at 48 weeks made no sense, since they had a whole arm that hadn't gone through the crossover part. So the study wasn't even completed before they presented the material. So that very disturbing to me. What was the motivation to present the study before it was ended? That really upset me, because I was asked to comment on the study, and I didn't know that. But a little embarrassed to find that out later on. That study did nothing to change my healthy skepticism about the procedure, but it didn't do anything to convince me to stop treating patients at all.